Welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we'll learn COBOL program structure. So this is the agenda. We'll learn program structure as well as we'll learn about divisions and sections in the COBOL program. So this is the structure of COBOL program. Inside a program, we have divisions. We have four divisions that we will discuss in the next slide. Inside divisions, we have some sections that are defined by COBOL as well as there are some user-defined sections as well. Then we have paragraphs. Inside sections, there are paragraphs. Paragraphs are user-defined paragraphs and you need to code them. Then we have sentences. In paragraphs, you need to write sentences. Further, we have statements and characters to form the sentences. Now, we'll start with divisions and sections. So, this is the identification division and this is the only mandatory division inside a COBOL program. If this is not coded, your COBOL program never gets executed. The reason behind this is in this division, we mention the program name as well as the programmer name. So next comes the environment division. In this division, we used to specify input and output files to the program which we are using. So these files, we will be putting them in the JCL. So from JCL, we will be passing the files. And in this division, we will tell them like these files we will be using and we will assign them a name. Then in environment division, we have two sections. One is configuration section that provides information about system on which program is written and executed. Then we have input output section. It provides information about the files to be used in the program. So here we declare the files in input output section. Then we have data division. Data division is used to define the variables used in the program. So we have further four sections. One is file section. In this, we define the structure of files which we will be using in the program. Then we have working storage section. It is used to declare temporary variables as well as the file structures which are used in the program. And then we have local storage section. So this one is similar to working storage section, but the only difference is variables allocated and initialized every time program starts execution. Then we have linkage section. It is used to describe the data names that are received from an external program. So in linkage section, we pass the variables. Suppose if we are calling a program from another COBOL program, in that situation, we will be using the linkage section. Then we have procedure division. This is the last division in which our logic is written. So it consists of executable statements using variables defined in the data division. So in this division, paragraph and section names are user defined. So inside procedure division, we declare the user defined paragraph names. Inside that, we write our logic and that logic is executed when we invoke the COBOL program using JCL. So let's see all these functions practically. We will start with program structure. I have coded one PDS where we'll be storing all our COBOL modules. We'll start with the structure. As you have already seen the diagram, we have program. Inside a program, we have divisions, sections, paragraphs, then sentences, statements, and characters. Now we'll see how they look in a COBOL module and how we code them. So this is our program. Program name is PGMSTRC. Then we will start with divisions. So we have four divisions. First is the identification division. This division is the first and only mandatory division of every COBOL program. The programmer and the compiler use this division to identify the program. In this division, the only mandatory field is program ID. In program ID, we specify the program name that can be up to 30 characters. Then we have author. This is an optional field. You can type the name of author here, or you can remove this also. Then we have environment division. In environment division, we have further two sections, configuration section and input output section. And in configuration section, further we have two paragraphs, source computer and object computer. Here in input output section, we have file control and we have one more input output control. So we'll start with configuration here. This section provides information about the system on which the program is written and executed. And there are two paragraphs. This is source computer. Here we used to specify
the system which is used to compile the program, and here we used to specify the system which is used to execute the program in object computer. So this is also an optional one. You can get the information from your organization. Then we have input-output control. Sorry, input-output section. It provides information about the files to be used in the program. Suppose we want to use a file. Now, how the program will know which file you are referring to? So in this section, we mention the file name and then we assign it to DD name. DD name is specified in the JCL. In JCL, we used to specify the DD name and then in front of that, we used to specify a file. So this is how we are linking a file from JCL to a COBOL module. And then this, how you want to access it, it should be sequential or random. So we'll discuss this in file section. Then we have data division. Data division is used to define the variables which are used in the program. So further, it has four sections. So file section, working storage section, local storage section, and linkage section. In file section, we used to define the record structure of the file. Suppose we have defined the file name here, and we have assigned it to a DD name. Now we will be defining its structure, and here in file section, we used to do that. We used to write FT, then file name, and then we define the structure of this file. Then we have working storage section that is used to declare the temporary variables and the file structures which are used in the program. This is working storage section. Then we have local storage section. This is similar to working storage section only. The only difference is that variables will be allocated and initialized every time a program starts execution. They are more or less same only. And then we have linkage section. So this section is used to describe the dataset names that are received from an external program. Then we have procedure division. This is used to include the logic of the program. Till now, we have declared the file, we have assigned the name to a program, we have declared the working storage variables. Now we need to write the logic. All the logic will be written in procedure division only. It consists of executable statements using variable defined in the data division. In this division, paragraph and section names are user defined. There must be at least one statement in the procedure division. The last statement to end the execution in the division is either stop run, which is used in the calling programs, or exit program, which is used in the call programs. So here you can see stop run. In coming videos, we'll cover what is exit program and what is calling modules and call modules. This is division. Inside this, we have declared directly the statements. So if you take these two, this is one separate statement, this is other separate statement, but if we combine, this is a sentence. Like we are displaying hello world and then we are displaying welcome to tutorials point. So we will say these both are a complete sentence and they are separate statements. So we have seen the divisions. Here division are identification, environment, data and procedure. Then we have sections. This is configuration section, input-output section, file section, working storage section, local storage section, and linkage section. Then further we have paragraphs. Here we can see paragraph, source computer, object computer. Similarly in all other divisions as well. Then we have sentences. Here you can see these two are sentences. Hello world and this. Welcome to tutorials point. Then we have statements. So separately, once this is one statement, this is other statement. And then we have characters, like H is a character, E is a character. So characters are lowest in the hierarchy and cannot be divisible. So this is all about program structure. In the next video, we'll see the basic syntax for a COBOL module.